the woman at the centre of all this, this woman, Jill Kelley, let's turn to you, Suzanne, on this. I want to play you a tape. It's a 9/11 tape of Jill Kelley calling the Tampa police near her home to complain about people who are around the house, citing her status as apparently an honorary consul. Let's listen to this.
You know, I don't know by any chance, because I'm an honorary consul general, so I have inviolability, so they should not be able to cross my property. I don't know if you want to get diplomatic protection involved as well, but now they could possess against the law to cross my property since this is now, like, you know, it's inviolable.
All right, no problem. I'll let the officers know.
Thank you.
Now, Suzanne, she seems to be laboring under some massive misapprehensions here. She's not entitled to any diplomatic immunity like this, right?
No, she's not. I mean, as an honorary, she's really not entitled to any of that. And it's, but you know, I think we're such, like, we're looking for information into who she is and what we know about her and all of this. So this is really the first time we've heard from her in her voice. And you can read into it what you want to. But no, she's not entitled to any of that.
I mean, I'm getting the feeling, watching her over the last 2 days, we've had the yellow dress, the pink dress, she's dressed to the nines, fully made up, looking for every, and I hate to say this, but looking like she's rather enjoying all the attention that she's receiving. We now believe, you know, if you believe what the people close to General Allen were saying, that she had contacts with all sorts of high-ranking military officials. But at the end of the day, Barbara, does this really matter? Does it have any real consequence? At the end of this, do we just have two women perhaps fighting for the attention of General Petraeus, one of whom he was having an affair with, one of whom he wasn't, and that this has somehow spiraled into this vast scandal when actually it never really needed to?
You know, other than they have great fashion accessories, you know, I think that there actually is something very important here. And we started talking about it last Friday night, didn't we? It's the question of the judgment of the generals involved. What on earth were they doing surrounding themselves with these kinds of people? Who warned them? Was this really a good idea? That's the fundamental question here. We pay these men a lot of money. What were they really doing?